Hey, PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. And we get a lot of questions on our podcast, The Full Nerd, that you can tune into. But sometimes we get the same questions over and over and over again. And one of them specifically I want to address here. In the past year, we've had a lot of high-profile launches, the RTXs, the 9900Ks, the 3900Xs, and a lot of times we get supply constraints and people want to kind of chime in and say, oh, well, you know, it's because of this or because of that, you know, and kind of say, oh, it's a paper launch. How much should we actually look into these supply constraints and why does it happen, do you think?
I think it definitely varies between, there are always different reasons. There are supply issues, making enough of them. They generally seem to stick at the high end though. 900K, those ninth gen parts were hard to come by. 3900X launched on July 7th, sold out July 7th. It's August, still a month later. I just checked, you still can't buy these things at most of the popular retailers. RTX, of course, really, really hard to come by. Those RTX 2080 Ti's were very difficult to find for at least, what, 2, maybe 3 months to get?
It took a while, yeah.
You know, I think a lot of it's because you know, clearly they don't have enough of them. This is not them just sitting on them in a warehouse and not sending them out to sell. It's because they just don't have enough of them. That could be issues with process. We didn't make enough of these. The other thing is these are very, on the high-end parts, they're harder to make. So 9900K is basically probably not every single CPU coming out from Intel is gonna hit 9900K clocks. For 3900X, it's two dies, not one die. For every 3700X, AMD can sell, you know, two. For every 3900X, they could sell two 3700Xs.
True, true.
So, and then for RTX, you know, everything is, it's always almost at the high end. And I think it's because if you're AMD, you're Intel, you're NVIDIA, you sort of figure, well, a lot of people are going to buy the mainstream price one. This high-end part, we're not going to make, you know, it's not 80% of the production run is on the high end.
True.
So it's hard, it's sort of hard to forecast because if Intel says, oh, we're going to make, I don't know, 10 million 9900Ks, they'd be sitting on 900Ks till the ears come out, right? So
probably
they try to forecast what the demand's going to be to basically make sure they sell them all. And I think they're underestimating the popularity of the very high-end parts. 3900X has been really hard to get because it's an awesome chip, right? It's an awesome chip. Same thing with all these things. And I think it's because these vendors go like, we didn't think people would go out and buy all these things. NVIDIA's like, we charge you $1,200 and you still bought every 2080 Ti for months, right? So from their point of view, you know, it's bad. They don't have them to sell you. You're getting angry. But at the same time, they didn't end up with an oversupply of the parts. And part of it, in my heart, I do believe they underestimate the demand for high-end parts.
Okay.
In the
end, you don't think there's a conspiracy?
There's no conspiracy. There's no Indiana Jones warehouse full of them. It is just simply they don't have the parts. They're harder to make. And they're very conservative. You don't want to get stuck with a whole ton of expensive things you can't sell for the rest of the year. And let me say something.
Yeah.
If you pre-ordered your part, you could have gotten it. Like if you pre-ordered any of the 3900X, you would have got it that
well,
first
but Gordon,
day.
Hold up. You tell me never to, and you and Brad
yes,
tell me never to pre-order.
I agree
right?
with that.
You got to wait for the reviews, wait for the third party
and
testing.
And that is the price to pay. The price to pay is, yeah, you're not going to, if it's really a hit, you're not going to get it.
Huh.
So I know everybody's like, never pre-order, and I do that too, but you know, at the same time, they're sitting at home with their shiny part for 3 months while you're sitting there with bupkis. Yeah. So
well,
that plus to them.
Do you think there is anything that can be done to kind of mitigate this? Should they do like the 3950X and wait a couple months to release it? Or, you know, should they just not take as many pre-orders? Or like, how can they get around this problem? Because it seems like every time one of these happens, people get angry, you know, and they want to know why it's happening.
I don't think there is, and I think the thing to do is always be conservative. If it's your money and you're an AMD stockholder, you want them to be conservative. you don't want them to like end up with a whole truckload of these things going nowhere. Same thing with Intel. You want to try to match the supply. And I don't think that's easy to do. Pre-orders actually do kind of help that a little bit, but you know what everybody says about pre-orders. So I don't think it's there's nothing you can do. Maybe go out and stand in front of Micro Center the day it comes out and buy it like people did with their Ryzen 9. So
yeah. So earlier you were saying it's hard to buy like a 9900K at launch or 3900X, but what about the other parts? They don't seem to be that constrained.
Yeah, and I just checked earlier when I was looking for 3900Xs, and I could go to stores and add a 3700X. I could add a 3600 to my basket. I could buy it if I had the money. So, you know, a month later, supplies of those are definitely better. At the high end, again, probably they did not properly forecast to meet the demand, but that is not necessarily a bad problem to have all the time. So, and, sure. You know, eventually, if you wait long enough, it all goes away. You can get 2080 Ti's and 9900Ks all day now. So yep. It's not a problem. You just gotta wait. You're not gonna be the first one to have it. Not necessarily always a bad thing to wait too. So I think it's okay.
All right, well, thank you for answering my question, Gordon. And tell him in the comments below if he's wrong, you know, or if you think there is actually a conspiracy. Yeah, or why we should pre-order, huh? Right, Gordon?
Yeah.
So anyway, if you want to get your question in, it's thefullnerd@pcworld.com. You can email us there. If we don't answer it on the show, maybe we'll answer it in a segment like this. So thanks for taking the time out to answer these questions, Gordon.